Breaking. Trump just made urgent announcement. This is so awesome. The government has been shut down for 3 days. But it is expected to reopen tomorrow. Senate Democrats forced the shutdown by filibustering on Friday. Thus, over the weekend, long and bipartisan talks took place over how to end the shutdown. Eventually, both sides came to an agreement. The government shutdown came about because Senate and House Democrats wanted DACA funding included in the continuing resolution budget package. However, it was not in it. Even though they agreed with everything else in the budget, including extending children's health insurance program funding for 6 years, Democrats refused to end the shutdown until DACA was discussed, while President Trump insisted he would not negotiate DACA until the government was reopened. The Independent Journal Review reported. On Monday, the Senate voted to end the government shutdown after just 3 days of being unable to reach a deal on the Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program and immigration reform. President Donald Trump repeatedly said that funding for the border wall would need to be included in the deal, and Schumer argued for DACA to be included, as well. In the end, Schumer gave into a plan where Democrats would accept a deal to end the shutdown in exchange for opening negotiations on DACA. The vote landed at 81-18. Now Trump has issued a statement saying that Democrats had finally come to their senses to fund the military, border patrol, first responders, and insurance for vulnerable children. He then said his administration would work toward solving the problem of very unfair illegal immigration, but only if it is good for our country. The president spent the weekend at the White House residence on standby should the Senate finally come to a conclusion. They did, however, it wasn't until Monday when a decision was made. While at the White House, the president was reported to be restless while on the phone with Republican legislators and some informal congressional aides. While some took issue over his notable absence from the discussions, he did exactly what he was supposed to. It isn't his job to craft a budget, it is Congress' job. His role is more of a principal, a lender of last resort, the last person you want to go to. Going to him indicates a failure on the part of Congress and the Senate to do their job and negotiate a bill that could pass. In the end, he won and thereby the American people won. USA Today reported. Yet Democrats on Monday made their own case for at least a partial victory. They noted that the new spending plan lasts less than 3 weeks, winning them a commitment to work on a permanent resolution to the issue of Dreamers, the undocumented immigrants who came to the U.S. as children. If there's no agreement by February 8, they warned, there could be a rerun of what Democrats called the Trump shutdown, which took place as both parties positioned themselves for congressional elections in a little less than 10 months. The Republican majority now has 17 days to prevent the Dreamers from being deported, said Senate Democratic leader Charles Schumer, DNY, speaking on the Senate floor. On Monday, Senate Democrats came together with Republicans on a short-term government funding bill, with a promise from Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, Arky, to work toward a bipartisan compromise on immigration, border security, and a broader budget outline before then. The vote was 81-18. Sanders said Trump hopes to sign the bill later Monday, after the House votes on the short-term spending measure and the budget office does necessary paperwork. Shortly after the vote, Trump met at the White House with a group of senators, all Republicans, and all viewed as relative hardliners on the immigration. The government has been partially shut down since 12:01 a.m. Saturday, after senators blocked a bill that would have kept the government funded for the next month. The legislation came up with a vote of 50-49, about 10 votes short of overcoming a Democratic filibuster. Democrats opposed the bill in part because it did not include provisions for young immigrants protected under the Obama-era Deferred Action for Childhood Arrivals program known as DACA. Trump announced in September that he would end the program, saying Obama didn't have the legal authority to give the undocumented immigrants legal status. But he also gave Congress 6 months to enshrine the program into law. Democrats argued the president was backing away from his commitment to finding a solution to help protect these 800,000 immigrants from deportation. We expect that a bipartisan deal on DACA will receive fair consideration and an up or down vote on the floor, Schumer said Monday. Trump himself has been largely silent throughout the shutdown crisis, except for an occasional tweet. But across the globe, Vice President Pence was quick to cast Democrats' efforts as a loss. "The Schumer shutdown failed," Pence said during a news conference in Israel, placing the blame squarely on the top Senate Democrat. "Now that the government is reopening, Congress can get back to work advancing the president's agenda. Share if you agree it was the #SchumerShutdown."